If you are in India, then the time shown on your clock, on your watch, on your mobile phone and your computer is IST, the Indian Standard Time. And IST is set as GMT plus 530. GMT stands for Greenwich Mean Time, and that 530 means time on all the watches in India will be 5 hours 30 minutes ahead of Greenwich Mean Time. But what is this Greenwich Mean Time? What is IST? Why it is 5 hours 30 minutes ahead of GMT? To understand all this, you'll have to understand the concepts of longitudes, latitudes and prime meridian. The concepts that are taught in high school geography. Let us revisit these concepts. Longitudes and latitudes are the lines we imagine drawn on the surface of Earth. These are the reference lines for mapping, navigation and timekeeping. Longitudes are the lines that run from pole to pole, north pole to south pole. You can see these yellow, white and red lines. I'll explain the color difference in a while. But all these lines that run from north pole to south pole are called longitudes. And the lines that are parallel to the equator, this is the equator of the Earth, all the lines parallel to this equator are called latitudes. These are the reference lines, just like drawing x and y axis to plot a graph on flat surface, on two-dimensional surface, or to map the two-dimensional surface. Earth has a natural reference latitude, that is the equator. Equator divides Earth into northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. But Earth doesn't have any natural reference longitude. Because of its rotation, there is no fixed reference longitude. And without the reference longitude, global mapping and global timekeeping is not possible. So, a reference longitude has to be selected. Currently, this longitude that passes through Greenwich Town near London in England, where the Royal Observatory is located, is taken as the global prime meridian. This particular longitude was selected as global prime meridian in the year 1884 during the International Meridian Conference held in Washington, D.C. in U.S. Delegates from 25 countries participated in this conference, and they decided that this, the longitude that passes through Greenwich, should be considered as the prime meridian for global use. The time on this prime meridian, or more specifically, the time at Greenwich is taken as the reference time to set all the watches and clocks across the world. And this time is known as Greenwich Mean Time, GMT. Each degree of longitude on either side, east side or the west side of this prime meridian, each degree corresponds to 4 minutes of time difference. All the places east of the prime meridian will have their time set as GMT, Greenwich Mean Time, plus some hours and minutes depending upon the longitude of that place. And all the places west of prime meridian will have their time set as GMT minus hours and minutes depending upon the longitude of that place. So coming back to IST, the Indian Standard Time. India is on the east of the prime meridian, and this particular longitude, the white colored one, which is 82.5 degrees from the prime meridian, this longitude, 82.5 degrees, is taken as the reference longitude for Indian timekeeping. So Indian Standard Time is maintained at Mirzapur, a town in UP, which lies on this longitude. So all the watches in India match this Indian Standard Time maintained at Mirzapur in UP, lying on this particular longitude, the reference longitude for India. This longitude, 82.5 degrees of prime meridian, is selected as the reference longitude for India because it lies midway between easternmost longitude and the westernmost longitudes of India. The easternmost longitude will be at the easternmost point of Arunachal Pradesh, and the westernmost longitude in India will be the longitude passing through the westernmost point of Gujarat. There is one more interesting thing here. Arunachal Pradesh is the eastmost or northeastmost state of India. Gujarat is the westmost state of India. The sun in Arunachal Pradesh rises 2 hours before it rises in Gujarat. So currently the longitude that passes to Greenwich is taken as prime meridian, the zero meridian, and all of the longitudes are measured with respect to this particular meridian. And this was decided in 1884. But was there any prime meridian before 1884? And where was it? In fact, there were many prime meridians before 1884. A lot of European countries had their own prime meridians, usually passing through their capital cities. So France had Paris meridian. Denmark had Copenhagen prime meridian. And centuries ago, Greece had its own prime meridian, and so did India. The oldest reference of ancient Indian prime meridian is found in Surya Siddhanta, the astronomical treatise dating back to 4th and 5th century, originally written in Sanskrit. Here, I have an English translation of Surya Siddhanta, the astronomical treatise dating back to 4th and 5th century, or maybe even earlier, because it seems this Surya Siddhanta that was written in 4th and 5th century is revised and updated Surya Siddhanta of earlier times. Shloka 62 of chapter 1 of Surya Siddhanta clearly defines the prime meridian of ancient India. Here is that shloka. What this shloka means is the Madhya Sutra, which is a prime meridian, is that which passes through Rakshasalaya, that is South Pole, Devatalaya, that is North Pole, and it also passes through cities of Rohitaka, which is current day Rohatak in Haryana, and Avanti, which is current day Ujjain in Madhya Pradesh. So there, a clear definition of prime meridian from ancient India. And according to this shloka, according to this definition, here is the prime meridian of ancient India. Starting from South Pole, going to North Pole, while passing through two cities that are mentioned in the shloka, Rohitak, which is current day Rohatak in Haryana, and Avanti, which is current day Ujjain in Madhya Pradesh. There is one more interesting thing about Ujjain. It's not only the prime meridian that passes through Ujjain, the Tropic of Cancer also passes through Ujjain. Tropic of Cancer is a latitude of 23.4 degrees north of equator. This 23.4 degrees matches with the tilt of Earth's axis. Earth's rotational axis tilts or makes an angle of 23.4 degrees with its plane of orbit around the Sun. Just like Tropic of Cancer in North Hemisphere, there is Tropic of Capricorn in Southern Hemisphere, and its latitude is also 23.4 degrees south of equator. Some interesting natural phenomena occur due to the tilt in the axis of Earth's rotation. The tilt with respect to Earth's orbit around Sun. This tilt is 23.4 degrees, as I mentioned earlier, and the phenomena that occur are the seasons. Seasons in Northern Hemisphere are exactly opposite to the seasons in Southern Hemisphere. So when there is summer in Northern Hemisphere, there is winter in the Southern Hemisphere. On summer solstice, Sun will be exactly overhead on the Tropic of Cancer, all over. So it will be overhead at this intersection as well. So Ujjain has this point of intersection of the prime meridian, ancient Indian prime meridian, and Tropic of Cancer. That point of intersection was known in ancient India as Nabhi, or the navel of the world. Interesting, isn't it? What's more interesting is Mahakaleshwar Mandir was built at that point of intersection. Mahakaleshwar means Lord of Time. Today, this particular point of intersection is shifted slightly compared to the ancient times when the Mandir was built. It is shifted a little bit because Earth's axis is not only tilted, but it also precises, just like a spinning top. So compared to earlier times, compared to ancient times, today this latitude degree is slightly different. And this point of intersection is shifted slightly from where Mahakaleshwar Mandir is. The exact date of construction of this Mandir is not known, but some sources say it was built in 6th century Common Era. What is known through Indian history for sure is it was attacked by the invader Shamsuddin Iltutmish in the years 1234 and 1235, he leveled this Mandir completely. He threw away Shiva Murthy. Mahakaleshwar is a form of Shiva. He threw away this Murthy in the nearby pond. He looted all the jewelry of this temple and took it to Delhi with him. This Mandir was reconstructed, but unfortunately it was attacked again in late 13th century by Jalaluddin Khilji and Alauddin Khilji. Again, it was rebuilt and restored. In 1734, Mahakaleshwar Mandir was built in its current form by Maratha General Rawji Shinde. It was renovated again by Sindhias in the 19th century. So, coming back to ancient Indian Prime Meridian, passing through Ujjain and coming back to city of Ujjain, Ujjain was the hub of astronomical mathematical studies. Ujjain was home to great astronomers and mathematicians, Brahmagupta, Bhaskaracharya and Varahamihira. All the ancient astronomers, Aryabhata, Brahmagupta, Bhaskaracharya, Varahamihira, use this Ujjain longitude as prime meridian. Al-Khwarizmi, the 8th and 9th century Persian scholar, also used this prime meridian for his astronomical works. So if we ponder over this, we will realize that the ancient Indian astronomers already knew that Earth is spherical. Not only that, it also rotated around its own axis, and they had conceptualized latitudes and longitudes, and they had defined the prime meridian. This Ujjain prime meridian was defined centuries ago, but it is still in use. Panchang, the Hindu calendar and almanac, uses this prime meridian, the Ujjain prime meridian. Panchang means five components. Panch means five. Ang means components. These five components of Hindu calendar and almanac are Vara, the day of the week, Tithi, the lunar day, Nakshatra, the constellation, Yoga, the lunisolar day, that is, the angles of sun and moon in the sky, and Karana, the half Tithi. Hindus refer to the Panchang to find out the Tithis, that the dates of their festivals. They also refer to Panchang to select auspicious day and time for the important occasions in life, like marriage or Grah Pravesh, which is housewarming ceremony. This Panchang goes beyond this, and it also forecasts the eclipses and the weather. It predicts whether it's going to be a great rainfall or it's going to be less rainfall, whether there is going to be a dry spell. There is a forecast in Panchang about this. So currently India uses two prime meridians. The Greenwich Prime Meridian for the current calendar that we follow, for the current timekeeping that we do. And it also follows its own ancient prime meridian passing through Ujjain, the Ujjain prime meridian, the Madhya Rekha, for making Panchang, the Hindu calendar and almanac. Amazing, isn't it? So if you like this video, do not forget to like it, share it, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.